Hi, hello, this is Anoop here, and in this video what we are going to see is Patch Connect Plus, right? What is Patch Connect Plus, how that can help Intune admins or SSCM admins. I'm going to concentrate on Intune and Patch Connect Plus in this video, checking for some application updates in Intune, MEM, Admin Center portal, and going through all those command lines and all those configurations, right? All those detection rules and requirements, everything is configured with a click of button, right? Everything, this application got created with a click of button, right? That's so easy. You just need to go to assignment then and deploy this application. That is it, what you need to do as an admin, right? MEM admin. The application creation process, everything will be handled by Patch Connect Plus, right? So this is Patch Connect Plus web console, and over here you can see third-party updates. The tab is there on the top. Then third-party updates, there are different tabs, right? Below that, there are different tabs. One is SSCM, that is Configuration Manager. The other one is Intune, right? You can do the update, third-party update publishing to SSCM as well as to Intune from this web portal, right? You can see pre-script, post-script, all those options are available, right? So that will reduce the packaging efforts from your side, right? Okay, so there are already a lot of applications available out of box as an out of box option, right? And as you can see, there are different numbers on the top, right? And columns, different columns as well. Published updates, available updates, and then published failed options and download failed options. I think those things are good for troubleshooting purpose. Right, and sync option is also there on the top right side. Yeah, these are the public published available updates options. These are the updates which we can publish to Intune, right? We are in Intune tab, and now just click off that button, right? Publish updates button. You are going to publish that update to Intune, third party update to Intune. For example, here you can see Mozilla. If you want to update that, you can do that, right? And search option is also there. That is the wrong search, because I use patch ID search box and I was searching for patch description, right? So you need to be a bit careful about that. Click on that and you would be able to see patch description search option, and over there probably you can search for your particular update. For example, if you're searching for Chrome or Oracle or some other application, right, application update that you want to publish to Intune, you can use this, right? Okay, so these are the Oracle updates available out of box, right? You don't need to do anything to make these updates available in Patch Connect Plus portal, right? That's done by Manage Engine team. Okay, so if you go to application management, you will see the similar options here. This is for creating new applications, right, in SSCM as well as in Intune. Okay, same here. 6 applications are already created, 739 applications are available. If you want those applications, you can create those applications, right? Here also you can see pre-script, post-script or columns, right? And you can upload your pre-script, post-script if you want. And there's a create application button also, right? So this is Intune. Again, Intune also has the same options. Created applications, available applications, 718 available application, and creation failed. Okay, that's interesting, right? And from the console itself, you would be able to know what is that, why the update has failed, or why the creation of application has failed, right? In Intune there could be several reasons, and you can dig into all those reasons. And download failed option is also there. Mm-hmm. Let's go back to third party updates. Let's go to Intune. Now it's showing published apps, I think, right? I clicked on that. Now I need to click on available updates. Okay, to show the list of available updates. Now I can see Mozilla. Probably I will try to publish that update. Okay, just click of a button, right? And there's a pop-up. You just need to confirm that. And the update publishing process is started now. You can check the status by clicking on click here button, right? Link over there, not a button, link over there. That will help you to understand the progress. Normally this is going to take a minute or so, maybe depending on the application size, etc. Right? It should complete soon. While waiting for that, let's move to SSEM and check what does this download fail option, right? And download fail option is pretty interesting, right? And you can see there's a button over there, upload and publish now, right? If you have for example Java account, username and account for your organization, you can download Java updates and upload it to Patch Connect Plus over here, right? And once uploaded, you can publish this into SSEM, either SSEM or Intune. That is pretty neat feature, right? And probably we can use this for LOB applications also, probably, right? If you have some internal application, in-house application, then probably we can use this feature. So let's go back and see what is happening. Okay, it was 8 before, now it's 9 published, and you can see Mozilla over there. That's good, right? Now created last published time and date are available over there. Now head back to Intune and check whether that particular application is available in there or not, right? I need to type Mozilla correctly, right? Okay, if I can type it. Okay, cool. So you can see update for Mozilla is available, that is published on 18th, right? Okay, that's cool. And this is the update for the previous version, which is already available in Intune portal, right? This has happened with just a click of button, right? By default, that published date is not available. Date created is not available. You need to add that column, right? If you want to confirm this. And I think that column is useful. Now, let's go back and go back to application management, okay, and try to publish some application into Intune, right? Let's try to create another application or application called KeePass, right, to save your passwords, right, to manage your passwords, right? You can use KeePass for that. So I'm publishing that application to Intune from Patch Connect Plus, and that is just a click of button, as you might have already seen in the previous example of third-party updates, right? So over here, click on the hyperlink, click here, and you will be able to see what is the status, etc. Let's go back to Intune. Okay, cool. Again, I'm struggling to type the spelling of KeePass. Let me try to find out what is it exactly. Okay, KeePass. It's K-E-E. Okay, fine. And you can see the published date is today's date. And all those things are ready, right? You just need to assign an Azure AD group to get this deployed, right? All the program details are already available, all those complex uninstalled command lines, all are automatically populated by Patch Connect Plus, right? That's pretty interesting, isn't it? And this has all happened with just a click of button, right? And this saves a lot of MEM admin time. As I mentioned, you just need to assign this application to Azure AD group. Okay, that's it. You are done with the deployment, right? That's pretty easy. So in this demo, we have seen two things, right? Third-party updates, how to publish third-party updates from Patch Connect Plus, how easy to search for updates, available updates, search for available applications, and we have seen some download failed alerts, right? And there are some upload options available for Java, etc. I have covered that also. And then we have seen application management options, right? How to publish application, etc., etc. Right. This was a quick demo overview of Patch Connect Plus. Hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Thank you all for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.